Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we shall start our class. Today we are going for the differential equation, that is the series solution of differential equation, Bessel's equation. Is my screen is visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us start the Bessel's equation. TBSJ already we have learned that yesterday, the Frobenius method. Frobenius method is used when a point x equal to x0 is a regular singular point. So here the special kind of the differential equation that is given by Bessel, that is called the Bessel equation. The differential equation of the form x square dty dx2 plus x dy dx plus x square minus n square y equal to 0. Or if we simply divide it by x square, then it will be coming d2y dx2 plus 1 by x dy dx plus 1 minus n square by x square into y equal to 0. This is called the Bessel equation of order n, and n being a non-negative constant. Here n is a non-negative constant. So this is the form of Bessel equation, that is x square d2y dx2 plus x dy dx plus x square minus n square y equal to 0. So as here x equal to 0 is a, if we put x equal to 0, here p naught x equal to x square and p1 x equal to x and p2 x equal to x square minus n square. If we put that p naught x at x equal to 0, then p naught x equal to 0, so it is a singular point, and moreover, x minus 0 into p naught x plus x minus 0 whole square, that is x square into p1x, that is also differentiable of all order. So we can say that x equal to 0 is a regular singular point of the given differential equation of Bessel. So for the Bessel equation, x square d2y dx2 plus x dy dx plus x square minus n square into y equal to 0. This equation is given by Bessel. According to the name of Bessel, it is known as the Bessel's equation. This is a very useful equation. So here x equal to 0 is a regular singular point. So how to solve this Bessel's equation? As x equal to 0 is a regular singular point, so we are using the Frobenius method to solve this. So for Frobenius method, yesterday already we have learned. So we have taken that y equal to, let us take that y equal to summation m equal to 0 to infinity am x to the power m plus k, where obviously a0 not equal to 0. This is the equation number 2. So as we got that y, so we can find out the dy dx. So dy dx equal to summation m equal to 0 to infinity am m plus k x to the power m plus 1. X to the power m plus k minus 1. This is the first power is 1. power of x is decreased by 1. So it is coming the value of dy dx. Now, from here, you have to find out that d2y dx2, that is also m equal to summation m equal to 0 to infinity am m plus k minus 1 into x to the power m plus k minus 2. Now, substituting the value of y, dy dx and d2y dx2 in equation number 1, we get actually equation number 1. If we say that this is the equation number 1, this one is not. This one is the equation number 1. Then we get, so we are, is it understood? Here we are as x equal to 0. Here x equal to 0 is the regular singular point. Take a one note. X singular point. X equal to 0. So we are taking that by Frobenius method, y equal to this. Then we got the value of dy dx and d2y dx2. Now we have to substitute this value in equation number 1. Now let us go for the next part. Just wait for 1 minute. So the form of Bessel equation is x square d2y gx2 plus x dy gx plus x square minus n square into y equal to 0. This equation is known as Bessel equation, and this Bessel equation is used to very useful thing for our series solution. So according to the name of Bessel, it is known as Bessel equation, and n being a non-negative constant here. N is a constant, but it is non-negative. It is a either zero or positive. So now we have to put these values in equation number one. Then we got all those things. Just wait for 1 minute. It should be. So we have to solve this Bessel equation for the next part. Actually, you have to substitute these values here, then it will be giving that x square d2y dx2 means summation m equal to 0 to infinity m plus k minus 1 into x to the power m plus k minus 2. This is the value of this, then plus x into value of dy dx summation m equal to 0 to infinity m plus k x to the power m plus k minus 1 plus it was x square minus n square into summation value of y m x to the power m plus k, this is equal to 0. Now, if we multiply by this x square, then this x to the power m plus k will be x to the power m plus k minus 1 plus 2. So, it will be given that x to the power m plus k. So, it will be given the summation m equal to 0 to infinity m plus k m plus k minus 1 into x to the power m plus k. Plus, when you multiply by this x, then it will be also x to the power m plus k. So, it will be given that summation m equal to 0 to infinity m plus k x to the power m plus k. Plus, when we multiply by this x square into this, then this will be x to the power m plus k plus 2. So this part will be summation m equal to 0 to infinity m x to the power m plus k plus 2. Then minus n square into summation m equal to 0 to infinity m x to the power m plus k. This is equal to 0. Is it understood? We're just multiplying by x, by x square, and then by x square into n square. Now, from here, if we take common that summation m equal to 0 to infinity m, then for the first part, it will be given that m plus k into m plus k minus 1. For this part, it will be given that plus m plus k. This is not here. Here it is minus of n square whole thing x to the power m plus k. And this part will be remain unchanged. That is summation m equal to 0 to infinity m x to the power n plus k plus 2 is equal to 0. Is this understood? We are taking the common summation m equal to 0 to infinity am into x to the power m plus k from first, second and last part. Then it is remaining that m plus k into m plus k minus 1 for the first part. For the second part, it will be m plus k. And for the last part, it is minus n square. So if we multiply infinity m, m plus k into m plus k, that is m plus k whole square, minus 1 into m plus k, that is minus of m, here it is plus of m plus k, minus n square into x to the power m plus k, and this part is remaining unchanged, that is m equal to 0 to infinity x to the power m plus k plus 2, this is equal to 0. Now here plus m plus k minus m plus k is cut, so it will be only given m plus k whole square minus n square, so it is a plus b into a minus b. So here we can write down that summation m equal to 0 to infinity m, that is m plus k plus n into m plus k minus n into x to the power m plus k, plus here it is remain unchanged, m equal to 0 to infinity m x to the power m plus k plus 2, this is equal to 0. Is this understood by everybody? If we give the name as this one, the calculation, what is done here? Hello? Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes. This is understood, no? Where each and every part is written step. Everything is clear here. So it was the Fibonacci method. So at first we have to put let us take that y equal to summation m equal to 0 to infinity am x to the power x minus 0, actually here x minus 0 whole to the power m plus k, where a 0 not equal to 0. Then we have to find out dy dx and d2y dx2, then put it into the original equation. We are putting this and getting this relation. Now here we have to equate the lowest power of x. What is the lowest power of x here in equation number 3? Can anyone tell me what is the lowest power of x here? What is the lowest power of x here for equation number 3? Anyone? What is the lowest power of x to x? Hello. I want some.
Hello, hello, sir.
What is the lowest power of x? No one can say that. What is the lowest power of x? Here m running over 0 to infinity. What is the least value of m here?
0.
0. Now if, then what is the lowest power of m? X. That is x to the power k, na? Plus 2. So what is the lowest power of x? X to the power k. when I put m equal to 0, then m equal to 0, that is a 0, 0 plus k plus n into 0 minus n into x to the power. If we take that coefficient of x to the power k, then this part is equal to, in the right hand side, what is the part of x to the power k? X to the power k is not present here, so that is 0. So equating the lowest power of x, that is x to the power k, in the both sides, we got a 0 into this. Or from here, we can write down that a naught into k plus n into k minus n is equal to 0, isn't it? And we know that, already we know that, as a naught not equal to 0, which implies that k plus n into k minus n equal to 0. So k equal to plus minus n. This is the value of z. Clear to everybody? So the roots of the initial equations are plus n and minus n. So the roots of the initial equation are is it understood by everybody? In Frobenius method, we have to find out the roots of the initial equation, then the according here both of the roots not equal, and about n there is nothing, is only we know that n is a non-negative, so minus n is the negative, so we cannot say that n and minus n, they are integers or they are fraction. Now next, equating to 0, next power of n, next lowest power of x is which one? Which one is the next power of x? Next lowest power? As right hand 0, so equating to 0, the coefficient of next, when we put k equal to 1, that is the next lowest power, which gives, what gives? Here you are putting m equal to 1, then it will be given a 1, 1 plus 1 plus k minus n into x to the power k plus 1, that is equal to 0. And we know that value of k equal to plus n and value of k equal to minus n. If we put k equal to n, then none of this part is 0. Is it 0? For k equal to n, if we put k equal to n, this part is 1 and this part. If we put k equal to minus n, then this part is 1 and this part is k minus 2n. A1 equal to 0. And equal to plus minus n, the x 1 plus k plus n into 1 minus n is not 0. Is it clear? When we put k equal to plus n, then also this expression not 0. When we put k equal to minus n, then also this expression is not 0. Then product of these three is given 0, but product of these two is not 0. Then only the condition is leads that a1 equal to 0. Is it understood by everybody or not? Hello? Is this understood? Am I audible to all? Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Is this understood? Why A1 equal to 0? Because of that, here the three products are given, the value of these three products equal to 0. But where both of 2 is not 0 is in the first bracket. Value of for k equal to n and for k equal to minus n. So only possibility that A1 equal to 0. So the this triple product is given 0. So from here, it leads to the condition that value of A1 is 0. Now we are going for the next slide. So from here, we leads to the condition. So A1 equal to 0 for k equal to plus. Lastly, equating to zero, coefficient of x to the power k plus n. For the first part, k plus m minus n plus. For the previous one, what will be that? A m minus 2, because of that last part was summation m equal to 0 to infinity m into a plus m plus 2. It was the last expression. So here we have to find out that x to the power m, how it will. Put m equal to m minus 2. Then this part will be given a m minus 2 x to the power k plus m means m minus 2 plus 2. This is a plus m. So from last this, a m minus 2 will be coming, that is equal to 0. Is it understood? X to the power k plus m plus 2. But we have to reduce this x to the power k plus m plus 2 into x to the power k plus m. Then we are putting m. Then we got that a m minus 2 into x to the power k plus m. So from last part, coefficient will be coming a m minus 2. Is it clear? From here, yes, we sir. Got one recurrence relation, that is we can find out the value of a m. So a m equal to minus of 2 divided by k plus n plus n into k plus n minus n. And this. Now putting m equal to putting m equal to 3, 5 odd part. 7 dot dot dot, it is equation number 4. In 4, we get, if we put m equal to 3, then a3 is equal to minus of a3 minus 2 by k plus 3 plus n into k plus 3 minus n. That is equal to minus of A1 by K plus 3 plus N into K plus 3 minus N. What was the value of A1? 0. Can you write this? Tell me. We are just putting the value of A1 equal to 0, so this is also 0.
Yes, sir.
For A5, it will be minus of A5 minus 2 by K plus 5 plus N into K plus 5 minus N, that is equal to minus of A3 by K plus 5 plus N into K plus 5 minus N. What is the value of A3? Value of A3 was 0. So this is also 0. So we can write down A1 equal to A3 equal to A5 equal to A7 equal to dot dot equal to 0. Na? All the odd power is coming 0. Na?
Yes, sir.
Now here two cases will be arised. Number one, for K equal to plus N. Number two, for K equal to minus N. Isn't it? Here are two cases will be arises for K equal to plus N and for K equal to minus N. So here all odd parts is coming 0. As A1 0, then A3 0, A5 G7, A9, all those odd part will be coming 0 from this arranged relation. Now we are going for the next part. Now two cases arise. Case one, when K equal to N. When K equal to N. From 4, we have by putting M equal to, previously we are putting that M equal to odd. Now M equal to even. Then what will be the value of A2? A2 is equal to minus M minus 2, that is 2 minus 2 by K. K plus M. Sorry, K means K plus M means 2 plus N into K plus 2 minus N. Now here K equal to N, putting this value minus A naught by K equal to N. N plus 2 plus N into here N plus 2 minus N. So from here we can write down that this is equal to minus of A0 by 2 into N plus 1, here N cut into 2. Isn't it? This is the value of A2. And value of A4 will be coming that A4 equal to minus of 4 minus 2 by K means N plus 4 plus N. This is 4. K means N plus 4 minus N, that is minus of A2 by N plus N, 2 into N plus 2, here N cut into 4. Now putting the value of A2, that is minus of 1 by 2 dot 4 dot N plus 2 into value of A2 is minus of A0 by 2 dot 2 dot N plus 1. So minus minus plus, it will be coming that A0 by 2 dot 2 dot 2 dot 4 dot N plus 1 into N plus 2. This is the value of A4 and so on. So every even part will be coming into the part of A4. A naught, isn't it? For A2, it is coming minus A naught by this. For A4, it is coming A naught by this. For A6 also, it will be coming for, look at here, for A2, it is coming minus. For A4, it is coming plus. when we taking that a6, then it will be coming again minus, isn't it? So it will be varies minus plus minus plus. So the solution is y equal to, it was the given condition y, what was the taken condition? Y was y equal to summation m equal to 0 to infinity m x to the power m plus k, a naught not equal to 0. It was our assumption. So if we write down this one, m equal to 0, then it is a 0 m equal to 0 x to the power k. Here k means the n, for k equal to n, for k equal to n, a 0 x to the power n plus, when we put m equal to 1, that is a 1 x to the power n plus 1 plus a 2 x to the power n plus 2 plus a 3 x to the power n plus 3 plus a 4 x to the power n plus 4 plus a 5 x to the power n plus 5 plus a 6 x to the power n plus 6 plus dot 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 so on. Now put the value of a naught, so it will be given a naught x to the power n. What is the value of a1? A1 is 0, so this part is 0, plus value of a2. A2 is equal to minus, that is minus a naught by 2 into n plus 1 into 2 into x to the power n plus 2, plus value of a3 was 0, plus value of a4 was a naught by 2 dot 2 dot 2 dot 4 dot n plus 1 into n plus 2, plus a5 is equal to 0 plus minus dot dot dot. Now if we take common from here, a naught x to the power n, a naught x to the minus x square, here from it is x square by 2 dot n plus 1 0 plus a naught is taken common, here it will be x to the power n plus 4, that is x to the power 4 by 2 dot 2 dot 2 dot 4 dot n plus 1 n plus 2 plus dot dot dot, like this, isn't it? Now if the value of p naught is taken as 1 by 2 to the power n gamma n plus 1, if we take the value of this, a naught equal to 1 by 2 to the power n gamma n plus 1, it is called the Bessel's coefficient. Bessel's give the value of a naught, so we are putting this here, we got the equation. This solution is called the Bessel's function of the first kind of order n, and Jn is equal to this. So from here we can write down a naught equal to this. So y equal to a naught means 1 by 2 to the power n gamma n plus 1 into x to the power n into 1 minus x square by 4 into 1 plus n plus x to the power 4 by 4 dot 8 n plus 1 into 2 plus n plus dot 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 dot, sorry, it will be minus minus dot dot dot. So jnx is order of n jnx, gamma n is a gamma function. So jnx is written as this. This is called the jnx is equal to, we can write down that x to the power n by 2 to the power n gamma n plus 1 into third bracket 1 plus of minus 1 into x square by 1 factorial into n plus 1. And here 1, 2 square. Then plus minus 1 whole square x to the power 4 by 2 to the power 4 into factorial 2 into n plus 1, n plus 2. This is the value of jnx. So from here we can write down that x to the power n by 2 to the power n gamma n plus 1 gamma n plus 1 summation r equal to 0 to infinity r equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole to the power r x to the power 2 r by r n plus 1 n plus 2 n plus 1 n plus 2 dot 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 r. In value of jnx, in terms of jnx is this, and it can be written that so jnx can be minus 1, sorry, just a minute. Minus 1 whole to the power r summation r equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole to the power r x by 2 whole to the power n plus 2r into 1 upon factorial r into gamma n plus r plus 1. N plus r plus 1. That can be written. This is called the Bessel's function of the first kind. Obviously, it is for a k equal to